Hello and a very warm welcome to Roving Camera. I'm Rashika Gangmani bringing you the highlights of the events that took place in the Parliament last week. On 28th of January, President of France-India Parliamentary Friendship Group, Ms. Selina Calvez, called on Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla at his office in the Parliament House.
President of the France-India Parliamentary Friendship Group, Ms. Selina Calvez, met Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla. At the outset of the meeting, Om Birla welcomed the French delegation to India and mentioned about the strong historical ties between India and France. Birla said that India and France share a deep cultural and historical bond based on mutual respect and shared values. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla also informed the French delegation that the Indian Parliament would also very soon set up an Indo-French parliamentary friendship group that would help deepen ties between the two democracies. On behalf of the French delegation, Ms. Calvez said that India is a great country with immense cultural and civilizational diversity. She added that Indian democracy is extremely vibrant and that Indian elections are a truly immense enterprise.
On January 30th, nation pays homage to the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, on his 72nd death anniversary. It was on this day in 1948, Mahatma Gandhi fell to the bullet of his assassin. The day is also observed as the Martyrs' Day.
President Ramnath Kovind, the Vice President M. Venkaiya Naidu, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla paid floral tributes to father of the nation Mahatma Gandhi on his 72nd death anniversary at Rajghat in New Delhi. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh, BJP veteran L. K. Advani, Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat, Army Chief General Manoj Narvane, Navy Chief Admiral Karambir Singh and Air Force Chief Air Chief Marshal R.K.S. Bhadauria were among those who offered tributes on Martyrs' Day. An inter-religious prayer meeting was organized on this occasion. Mahatma Gandhi, the nationalist who led India to freedom from the oppressive British colonial rule, was assassinated on January 30, 1948 at the age of 78. Mahatma Gandhi gave Indians the vision and confidence that they were equal to the British and showed that they can defeat the greatest power of the world through peaceful means. He got everyone together and led the mass movement of freedom struggle. January 30th is thus marked as Martyrs' Day.
On January 30th, Vice President M. Venkaiya Naidu, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla and Union Minister of State, Culture and Tourism Prahlad Singh Patel attended the Sarvadharma Prarthana at the Gandhi Smriti on the occasion of Mahatma Gandhi's death anniversary, the Martyrs' Day in New Delhi.
The Vice President M. Venkaiya Naidu, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the Speaker Lok Sabha Om Birla, MOS Culture and Tourism Prahlad Singh Patel and other dignitaries attended Sarvadharma Prarthana at the Gandhi Smriti on the occasion of the Martyrs' Day on the 72nd death anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi, the man who led India to freedom from the British colonial rule, was assassinated on January 30, 1948. He was assassinated by Nathuram Godse, who was against Gandhi's idea of partition. Bapu, as he was lovingly called, played one of the most prominent roles in India's freedom struggle through non-violence and peaceful ways.
Ahead of Parliament's budget session, Minister of Parliamentary Affairs Prahlad Joshi called on all party meet with the leaders of parties in the Parliament Library building on 30th of January.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Defence Minister Rajnath Singh, Parliamentary Affairs Minister Prahlad Joshi, Congress leaders Ghulam Nabi Azad, Anand Sharma, TMC leader Derek O'Brien and NCP leader Supriya Sule attended the meeting. Besides, LJP leader Ram Vilas Paswan, Samajwadi Party leader Ram Gopal Yadav, Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs Arjun Ram Meghwal also attended the meeting. Ahead of Parliament's budget session, Prime Minister Narendra Modi assured at the all-party meeting that the government is ready to discuss all issues. The first phase of a budget session began with President Ramnath Kovind's address to a joint session of both the houses on January 31st. The economic survey was tabled on the same day and the budget presented on Saturday. Also, 45 bills are likely to come up during the budget session.
एक तो चिंता हमने प्रकट की है कि पार्लियामेंट का सत्र आहिस्ता आहिस्ता पिछले कुछ सालों से श्रिंक हो रहा है, घट रहा है। एक वक्त में 3 महीना होता था, तो अभी इस दफा 2 अलग-अलग डेटों में सेशन चल रहा है और कुल मिलाकर 1 महीना, तो ये बढ़ाना चाहिए। और दूसरा चिंता हमने प्रकट की कि सरकार का ध्यान जो है वो पूरा आकर्षित रहता है कि बिल पास हो। बिल पास करने में हमें कोई आपत्ति नहीं, विपक्ष पूरी तरह से जो भी देश हित में, जनता के हित में जितने भी कानून बनाए जाने चाहिए, विपक्ष पूरी तरह उनको अपना समर्थन देता। लेकिन नए कानून बनाने के साथ साथ देश में बहुत सारी चीज़ें चल रही, उनकी तरफ हमने सरकार का ध्यान आकर्षित किया। जिस तरह से आर्थिक हालत आज पूरे देश की खराब हुई है, जिस तरह से जीडीपी नीचे जा रहा है, जिस तरह से देश में बेकारी और बेरोजगारी, किसानों की जो हालत है उसके बारे में कोई उनको फिक्र नहीं है, तो ये तमाम चीज़ों के बारे में हम लोगों ने कहा है कि पार्लियामेंट में जहां सरकार उत्सुक है कानून बनाने में, वहां विपक्ष चाहेगा इन तमाम मुद्दों पे चर्चा होनी चाहिए, डिस्कशन होना चाहिए, इनका समाधान होना चाहिए।
द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट इशू दैट इज दैट द पेट्रोलियम सेक्टर हैज इशूड अ नोटिफिकेशन ऑन 15/1/2020 ऑन द पोंगल डे, ऑन द हार्वेस्ट फेस्टिवल डे ऑफ तमिलनाडु, दैट द नोटिफिकेशन सेज आर कॉलिंग फॉर एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट फॉर एक्सटेंडिंग द न्यू ब्लॉक्स टू द इन द डेल्टा एरिया। डेल्टा एरिया कंटेन्स more than 14.47 hectares of land, which for the which traditionally for the more than 4000 years the farmers of delta are producing more than 40 million tons of paddy from the particular delta area, and it definitely if the notification holds good, definitely this delta area will become a desertified area. So these things will definitely build press for the discussion.
राजस्थान में जो टिड्डी का हमला हुआ है, बाड़मेर से लेकर बीकानेर, हनुमानगढ़, गंगानगर, तमाम जिलों के अंदर, उसमें राजस्थान की सरकार मुआवजा नहीं दे रही, किसान आत्महत्याएं कर रहे हैं। इस मामले को पुरजोर तरीके से उठाएगा केंद्र के सरकार में, राजस्थान की सरकार केंद्र के पाले में बोल डाल रही कि भाई केंद्र वाले मुआवजा देंगे, तो इसमें प्रधानमंत्री जी आपको हस्तक्षेप करना चाहिए। बजट सत्र है, टिड्डियों के मामले में केंद्रीय अध्ययन दल वहाँ पे जाए और टिड्डी प्रभावित क्षेत्रों का वहाँ आंकलन करे कि खरबों रुपए की फसलों का नुकसान हुआ और कहीं न कहीं टिड्डियाँ कोई 20-25 साल बाद आई है, ये 3-4 साल लगातार आएगी, इसके बारे में भी आपको हस्तक्षेप करना चाहिए। दूसरा, हमने कहा कि छोटी पार्टियों को ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बोलने का समय मिले।
ग्लोबल पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द इकोनॉमी, ग्लोबल पर्सपेक्टिव, ग्लोबल सिचुएशन एज फार एज इकोनॉमी इज कंसर्न, how India can take the advantage of situation, Pradhan Mantri ji ne kaha sirf charcha nahi, samruddh charcha hona chahiye aur us structured debate hum chahte hain, sami muddon par hum charcha karne ke liye bhi taiyar hai, especially ye jo global perspective mein, global situation ke perspective mein charcha karke bharat uska kaisa labh utha sakte hain, इसके लिए हम सभी आपने जो सुझाव देते हैं, सुझाव हम पूरा तरह से सुनने के लिए तैयार है, वो स्वीकार है, वो स्वीकारने के लिए तैयार है। राष्ट्रपति जी के जो अभिभाषण होता है उसके ऊपर जो चर्चा भी चलते हैं उसके ऊपर उसमें तो सभी मुद्दों को आप एड्रेस कर सकते हैं, सरकार पूरा उत्तर देने के लिए तैयार है। फिर भी अगर वो चाहते हैं तो स्पेसिफिक मुद्दे पर चर्चा हो, सरकार उसके लिए तैयार है।
We'll take a short break here and be right back on the other side with more parliamentary news. Welcome back to Roving Camera, a program that brings you the highlights of the events that took place in the parliament last week. Ahead of parliament's budget session that started on 31st of January, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla called for an all-party meet on Thursday.
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla on Thursday chaired an all-party meeting with the leaders of parties in the House ahead of the beginning of the budget session in Parliament. The meeting of the winter session was held in the Parliament Library Building. The budget session is divided into two parts. The first part began on January 31st and will continue till February 11th, after which the session will be adjourned for a short break. The second half of the session will begin on March 2nd and will continue till April 3rd. The Lok Sabha Speaker calls the all-party meeting before the commencement of any parliament session to seek cooperation from floor leaders for the smooth functioning of the House.
Sabhi dalon ke netaon ne aashwast kiya hai ki sadan bina vidhan ke chale, bina badit chale. सदन जनता के प्रति उत्तरदायित्व रहे, इसलिए सदन की कार्रवाई चलना चाहिए। मैंने भी सभी फ्लोर के नेताओं से आग्रह किया है कि सदन की कार्रवाई बिना बाधित चले, सदन में सबको पर्याप्त समय और अवसर हर विषय पर बोलने का दिया जाएगा। मुझे आशा है कि यह सत्र भी जनता की अपेक्षाओं और आकांक्षाओं के अनुसार चलेगा। सभी दलों ने कहा है कि सदन चलने में हम सहयोग करेंगे और यही मेरी अपेक्षा है और सभी सदन के अंदर जो फ्लोर नेता थे वो इस बैठक में आए थे और उन्होंने जो जो विषय जो जो सुझाव रखे उन सब सुझावों पर विचार किया जाएगा, लेकिन सदन चले इसकी सहमति बनी है।
Simultaneously, Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu called an all-party meet with the leaders of parties at his residence on January 31st.
Those who attended the meeting include Deputy Chairman Rajya Sabha Harivansh, Leader of the House Thawar Chand Gehlot, Leader of Opposition Ghulam Nabi Azad, Minister of Parliamentary Affairs Prahlad Joshi, External Affairs Minister Jai Shankar and Minister of Railways Piyush Goyal. The Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu reminded the leaders of the good work done by the Rajya Sabha during the last two sessions in terms of productivity and quality of debates and urged them to ensure the same positive momentum during the budget session. He said that the budget session offers ample opportunities to raise and discuss all issues of wider public concern during the long debates. He also advised leaders to ensure that members belonging to respective parties come prepared to make effective contribution to the debates in the House.
Parliamentarians paid floral tributes at the portrait of former Speaker of Lok Sabha, M. A. Iyengar, in the Central Hall of Parliament House on his birth anniversary. M. A. Iyengar was a veteran freedom fighter and eminent parliamentarian. He was a member of the Central Legislative Assembly, Constituent Assembly, Provisional Parliament and First to Third Lok Sabha.
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, Deputy Chairman Rajya Sabha Harivansh and former Deputy Prime Minister L. K. Advani paid floral tributes at the portrait of a former Lok Sabha Speaker M. Anantasayanam Iyengar in the Central Hall of Parliament House on his birth anniversary. Among others who paid tributes were Members of Parliament, former Members of Parliament and Secretary General of Lok Sabha, Snehlata Srivastava. After the sudden demise of the then Speaker, G.V. Mavalankar, he was unanimously elected to preside over the Lok Sabha on 8th of March 1956. Iyengar was once again unanimously elected the Speaker of the Second Lok Sabha in 1957. Though elected to the Third Lok Sabha, he resigned soon after to assume office of the Governor of Bihar. M.A. Iyengar passed away on 19th March 1978. On the initiative of Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, an exhibition of books on M.A. Iyengar, available in the Parliament Library, was held in the Central Hall of Parliament House.
With that, we have come to the end of this edition of Roving Camera. We'll see you next week with all the news in and around the Parliament. Keep watching Lok Sabha Television.